Hi guys. So I decided that I was going to post all of my proxy site hauls for you on my channel. And as you can see, these boxes are already open. So I've actually removed all the contents already because this package came late last night. So I guess a little bit of story time concerning this package and some of the things I was kind of dissatisfied with Zenmarket in particular. So when I went to request all of my items to be consolidated, they ended up putting it into two different boxes. And these boxes are not that big, especially if you saw my last haul. Those are pretty substantially large boxes, and these two, like the contents of these two packages could have easily fit in those. But for some reason, they decided to put them in two boxes. And I tried doing the cheaper method, which is DHL Express, but they messaged me after I sent in that request, and they already told me how much it would cost and said that the weight was a little too heavy. And I did check the weight, and it was kind of right where the limit was for the DHL Express guidelines were. But I thought, okay. And the next cheapest option was UPS, which was about $20 more expensive. So really it wasn't that much more. And the benefit of using UPS instead of DHL Express is that this pack, or both of these packages, came within 2 days of me paying for shipping, while DHL Express would take about a week. And so both of these came really late last night. The delivery guy actually just left them on at my front door, so I didn't even know they were there for a while. I didn't have to sign for them or anything, which was also pretty concerning. I don't know if that was UPS's fault or they just didn't have a signature confirmation required, but I don't know. The things that were in here were really expensive, so it was a bit concerning that they just left them at the front door. But anyway, I am going to show you now what was in these packages and kind of the minimal protection that they put in here. So right now I just have kind of all the wrappings in here. So we'll start with this box, because this box actually had bubble wrap in it, while the contents in this box didn't have any bubble wrap, as I'll show you in a second. But I didn't order too many larger items. I ordered a lot of photo books and photo cards, is what made up most of this package. And so there's only kind of this amount of bubble wrap used, which is fine for this box, but because there wasn't any bubble wrap in the other box, I was kind of wondering what was up, because the last two times I used Zenmarket, everything was nicely packed and secured, as I showed in my last haul video. And then to fill up the empty space, they kind of just filled it with this newspaper here. So nothing too exciting. It's a really small box, and I just felt like I paid more shipping than I really needed to in the end. But anyway, and then the second box here was actually put around another box, so really you have the weight of two cardboard boxes added to this package. So let me get this. I don't know if UPS has like a flat rate box or something, so they had to put a UPS box for the package to ship through UPS, but I'm not totally sure. But it just seems a little odd they would put two boxes within each other like that. But as you can see, everything had like plastic wrap on all the cards or photo books I ordered. And you could see our guess kind of a lot of what I ordered had to do with, especially all these, which is why the contents of this box was rather pricey. And so there are some top loaders and whatnot. But all this was provided from the sellers. So it wasn't Zenmarket themselves who packaged any of this, I don't believe. So yeah, that was it for what was inside packaging-wise for the these boxes. I'm gonna show you what I ended up buying. All right, so what I got in this box were all the things I bought around the end of August and September. So both of those months were rather expensive for me, mostly due to all of the Junho things that were happening. So Junho had his end finale of his Japanese tour, which had a new set of goods from when he started his Japanese tour for 2017 SS. And then a couple weeks later, he had his Korean concert, which had a new set of goods that were rather expensive because he only had the concert for one day. And as you can imagine, when you have limited goods, especially from a Korean event, and you're trying to buy these things on a Japanese website, the prices are going to be rather marked up. So I didn't end up buying as much as I would have liked to, but I did pay a pretty penny for some of these things, I will say. Anyway, I'll start off with things that are not related to 2PM that I got. And I'll start with MYNAME. So I got both of NSU's web versions of their single they released earlier this year, and then their full album, MYNAME Is. And so I'm probably not going to open these. I'm just going to keep the plastic wrap over them, just because the contents of the CD is not different from the MYNAME Is album I already own. And this single doesn't have any other kind of tracks other than an instrumental that MYNAME Is would have. Those were those. And then I also finally got something from Park Jungmin. And so Park Jungmin, if you're not familiar with him, he's from one of the members of SS501. And he just recently finished his military services. And he actually has a lot of great Japanese solo work that really fits to my taste. If you like anything from Jaejoon, from JYJ, kind of that more rocker edge sort of music, Park Jungmin, or he also goes by Romeo in Japan as his kind of solo artist name, really has something kind of similar to that rocker Jaejoon music. And so I ended up getting this box set of his Wake Me Tonight singles. And so this comes with five different CDs, and they all have different songs on here. So you get like 10 tracks in total, I think. Or actually probably even more than that, because there are some, I want to say half songs, but not like full songs, but they all kind of nicely blend together to form kind of a single album, but you just have it in five pieces. And they also come with these like inserts and these kind of jacket cards too. It's just neat. But it's really hard to find Park Jungmin's things. His stuff is only sold at Tower Records Japan, and for some reason I just can't find them on these proxy sites. I don't know if it's because he was gone for so long. And so when I was looking for them actively, just no one was selling them at the time. But now that he's back, and he's going to have a new single and album soon, hopefully those pop up more so I could get them. There's that. So that was it for CDs. And then I also ended up getting two different DVDs. So I got Toho Shinki's or TVXQ's Tone and Tree concert DVDs. So these are limited edition versions, so they come with a little mini photo book and then three DVDs. And so TVXQ is one of my favorite groups, and their Japanese stuff is wonderful, and I'm just a sucker for live DVDs. So I had to get these, of course, and now I'm just missing kind of two of them, so I'm missing Time and Width, so I'll have to get those eventually. But for now, I have these two. And now I'm going to be showing you all the photo books that I got, because I did get quite a few photo books, and that's why I think the packages are a bit heavier than I expected. So start with this one. And this is actually a concert good that you could buy at Junho's Hyper Tour. And so what's in here are all pictures of Junho's two cats, Johnny and Wari. And these are just pictures he took himself, and he compiled them into this little photo book. I kind of wish I read Japanese so I know what the little captions are, because I imagine they're cute. But if you don't follow Junho on Instagram, you're missing so much on his dad pictures of his cats. It's the cutest thing. He just loves his cat so much and loves posting about them. And then the other Junho-related photo book I got was his Canvas concert tour kind of brochure. So Canvas was the title of his Korea mini album, and so he had a concert in Korea by this name. And I'll just flip through this because the pictures in here are lovely. This did cost quite a bit of money compared to how much it sold for at the venue, but I think this is just going to be something really difficult to find in the future, so I'm glad I grabbed it. But you just have Junho and a cuddly orange sweater and ripped jeans, and just lovely. So that's that. And then the rest of the photo books are from fansites. And so I try to get fansite goods from 2PM whenever they pop up on proxy sites. And luckily 2PM is one of those groups that do have just a lot of fan goods available on the secondary market for reasonable prices. So this first one I got was actually a DVD for Junho. And so this was really cheap. I think it was like 2,000 yen that you could buy it out for with free shipping. So it comes with a little mini photo book, and then you get this DVD. So this comes with 5 discs. I have not watched a fansite DVD before, so I'm interested to see how those go. And then it comes with a bonus DVD. So really, you're getting 6 DVDs here. And then inside this bag are just some extras. And I really like these stickers, they're really cute. And just some photos. And then I got 4 other fansite photo books that are a little larger than I expected. And they're not of Junho, they're of Chansung, who, if I had to pick kind of a second favorite, Chansung or Junkae would probably be tied for that slot, but really I do love all of 2PM. But I got a lot of photo books from him. So these are all kind of earlier kind of fansite photo books for Chansung. I'll just do a quick flip through so you can see some of the images. And this did come with a calendar. And so the reason why I kind of hopped on buying these is because all of these are from the same seller and they were selling them for 300 yen each, which is like under $3. So of course I had to grab these. So initially I just thought they were just for the photo book themselves, but the seller threw in a ton of extras as well. So I think there are extras that came with these photo books when they got them initially. So I got 4 different ones as you see here. And really, I really enjoy all of them. Fansite photo books are just so fun. It's kind of cool to see from the fans' perspective who are going to all these events and what photos they select and where they kind of organize them in these little photo books for other fans. It's just kind of, I think, a neat concept. But even though kind of all these were taken kind of at the same events or during some time period, they all kind of spoke a different story, which I thought was kind of neat. My favorite being Masquerade. I thought this fan site, so I think this is actually a collaboration between 2 different fan sites. So Barrage and Sue, looks like. But that one, I thought they had a really kind of cool thing going on with how they organized pictures. And then this treasure box photo book was also lovely, as well as the other two. But I thought these two kind of stood out. So all the fansite goods that came with those photo books are here. So they gave me a lot of L holders. This is one when they were advertising for, I think, this water company. and then I got two from one of the movies Chansung was featured in. I'm not sure which one this is, but it's in Japanese movie. I guess it's called Red Carpet. It has just two images that are different on the back. Then I got this one. So this is fan-made, and this is from the Masquerade photo book. And then all the goods that came with all of these. So I think, I'm not sure exactly which fan site had which kind of goods with them, but there's some photos here, some smaller cards, and a sticker. It's like a little cleaner for your phone or device, and more photo cards. So that was a nice surprise. So I'll have to make room in my photo card binders for more, I guess, fansite goods for all the other members. So I feel like I keep adding more binders to my tube fan collection. It's been a little ridiculous. Right now I have four kind of dedicated tube fan binders, and it's a bit of a problem. Anyway, now on to all the photo cards I ended up buying, which a lot of these did cost a pretty penny. But yeah, I did kind of go overboard with photo cards this time. Though, a lot of these are kind of rare ones that are I don't usually see pop up often, and they're for decent prices, so that's why I decided to buy them all in one go. So I decided to kind of cut back on my collection and try to sell some things to make up for damage from the prior few months. And I do have another, and I didn't mention this, but I do have a lot of other things still in the Zenmarket warehouse that I haven't shipped out yet. So it's just kind of more things that accumulated over the past few months that was a little ridiculous. But anyway, the cards I got this time, so for smaller ones, I got the kind of, so they had at his Canvas concert, they had like a scratch card, so similar to what they did for Six Nights. And if you got a four, you get this kind of gift photo card. And then I got actually two of these. I think they both came in different bundles, deals. But this is another kind of, I think they're called like signature cards, but you get this at one of Junho's concerts, and this is something you have won from one of his lottery tickets. There are those. And now I'll show you some of the more rare ones that I did kind of pay a bit of money for, but really they're a lot cheaper than what I usually see them go for, which is why I bought so many. But I have all these venue specific last night ones. See here. So I ended up getting 9 of these, which honestly, when I started collecting Junho's venue cards, I didn't think I would be collecting any of these because of how expensive they end up being, but it's really hard to resist. I really like this set. You really can't go wrong with, I guess, shirtless Juno, but they don't want to focus, do they, today? But yeah, that was it for last night. And then I got this 6 days higher one. So this one, I'm not really sure what the rare ones are, or if there are rare ones for the set, but this one's always really expensive. And it's the cutest one because he's squinting his eyes. But finally have that one. And then I got this Chansung one. So this is from House Party, one of the kind of mail-in order ones. And then I got this kind of, one of the last Six Nights one from this set for Juno. I just need one more of him in this suit, and that will be complete. And then I got this Chansung one, so this is from 2 p.m. to 2 p.m., which is one of the mail-in kind of live photos. And then I got the set for Wooyoung's Party Shots. So these are, again, mail-in fan set that you could buy after the concert. And then I bought this set of all these Jun-K No Shadow cards. And I'm not going to keep all of these. I think I'm just going to keep six of them, because that will work nicely in my photo card binder. So I'll be selling the rest. And then the thing that I kind of went overboard with were all of Juno's 2017 SS concerts in Yokohama. So that one, they came out with 50 different styles of these trading cards. And so previously there were 70 of them in the kind of ice cream theme ones I think I showed previously. But all of these ones, as you see, that I have a stack of 50 actually. So I don't have all of them. I have 45 of the 50 total. And so I have five extras that are duplicates, but you probably could guess why it was hard to resist buying all these at once. So I ended up just buying a lot of these in bundles, which I think is the easiest way to kind of make sure you get most of these cards. Because it's really difficult to get these one at a time like I've been doing well after an event. And it's much cheaper to do it this way, though the initial cost is pretty high. But just Junho in this photo shoot just kind of kills me, especially with that like little ribbon tied around his neck. Goodness. But I'll try to flip through all these, because as I said, there are 45 different types, and then I have five at the end that are my extras. But yes, I need to figure out how these are going to go in my photo card binder now, because I am running out of room in those last five, or the extras I had. But yes, that was all the things I got in this haul, which ended up costing me a lot of money, but it's okay. I ended up selling a lot of things too, so it kind of worked itself out in the end, and I'm still selling things to make up for a few things that are still in the warehouse. But as I like to say, collecting K-pop is a vicious cycle. Anyway, that is it for this haul. I will probably have another Zenmarket 2 package coming within the next couple of weeks, because I still have a lot of things that are still there. But yes. But anyway, hope you guys enjoyed this haul. Let me know if you have any questions regarding any of these things. I was considering doing a video about collecting 2 p.m. photo cards or just their stuff in general, because I know there's not that many resources out there, and I've had to do a lot of kind of just searching myself to figure out what's actually available and all that, and it's overwhelming, especially considering all their Japanese things could add up to a lot. So if any of those videos sound interesting, do leave it down in the comment section, or if you have any thoughts regarding anything, just love to hear from you guys. Anyway, that's it.